everyone. How's it going today? My name is Mr. Will. I am so happy to be with you all here for AG Kids Online. We've got a lot of fun stuff to do today, and we've got a lot of great things to learn about. We are going to learn today that Jesus was the good shepherd who cares for his people. So have you ever heard of a shepherd before? Does anyone know what that is? I want you to raise your hand at home if you know what a shepherd is. Literally, it's someone who takes care of sheep. They protect, they lead, they guide, and they take care of sheep. And so today, I'm gonna give you guys a chance to pretend to be sheep and shepherds. What sound does a sheep make? Turn to your brother or your sister, just, you know, give them your best sheep sound as loud as you can. It's gonna be fun, right? What sound does a sheep make? But we're gonna play a game to get started where you get to pretend to be sheep and shepherds. So here's how it's gonna work. One person in your family will get to be the shepherd. So you're gonna need some help for this. You can't play by yourself. You need your brothers, your sisters, your mom, and your dad. And one of you will get to be the shepherd. And the shepherd's job is to lead the sheep into the sheep pen. So that can be anything. You can choose like a corner of the room. You can choose your couch, a chair, anything. That can be the sheep pen. And all the sheep, so everyone who's not the shepherd, will just kind of wander around the room. And the shepherd's job is to go after them and lead them back to the sheep pen. But the shepherd can only lead one sheep at a time. So let's say your little sister is one of the sheep and you lead her to the pen. Awesome, right? But then you leave to go get your brother and then your sister leaves. So you can only lead one sheep at a time. So it's gonna get kind of crazy. And you can play multiple rounds if you want, if different people wanna try being the shepherd. So enjoy that game. Go ahead and pause the video and play a couple rounds if you want. And then come right back here and we'll connect that to what we're going to learn about today. Hope you guys had a great time playing the game. Hope you're able to take some turns being the shepherd. But if you did get to be the shepherd, that probably felt impossible, didn't it? Because, you know, once you get your brother onto the couch, your sister would just go away and you couldn't get all the sheep and the shepherd at one time. And so it's kind of useless to have a sheep pen if there's no gate and there's no fence, right? That's kind of what the game was all about. But today we are going to learn that Jesus said that he is the gate to the sheep pen. We're going to learn that he is the good shepherd who cares for his people. So where do we learn about Jesus? What do you think? Where do we learn about Jesus? Absolutely right. We learn about Jesus from the Bible. So I want you guys to go and grab your Bibles. We are going to be in the Gospel of John today, chapter 10. So go ahead and turn there. It's in the New Testament, but that's where we're going to be learning today that Jesus is the Good Shepherd. So we're going to go ahead and watch a video that's going to teach us more about what that means.
Jesus told a story to the Jewish leaders. If a person climbs into a sheep pen, he is not the shepherd, he is a thief. A shepherd enters the pen through the gate. When the sheep hear the shepherd's voice, they recognize him and follow him. A shepherd calls his sheep by name and he leads them. If the sheep hear the voice of a stranger, they will run away. The people did not understand Jesus' story. Jesus was talking about God's people as sheep. The Jewish leaders were the stranger and Jesus is the shepherd. Jesus said, "I am the gate for the sheep. They come in through me and are saved." Jesus was saying that he is the gate that leads to true life. People who come to him are like sheep who come to green pastures. Jesus warned, "A thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy." Jesus was talking about the devil, who does not want people to follow God. Jesus said, "I have come so that they may have life. I am the good shepherd who lays down his life for the sheep," Jesus said. "I know my sheep, and my sheep know me." Like a shepherd risks his own life to protect his sheep from wolves, Jesus was willing to die for his people. Jesus came to do his Father's plan, and he was going to die and rise again. The Jews argued with one another. Many said, "Don't listen to him. He has a demon. He's crazy." Others said, "That's not true. How can a demon give sight to the blind?" the Jewish leaders asked Jesus, "Are you really the Messiah? Just tell us." Jesus answered, "I did tell you, but you did not believe because you are not my sheep. My miracles prove who I am." Jesus reminded them that he is the good shepherd. "My sheep hear my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life and they will never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. The Father and I are one." Jesus is the good shepherd. God sent him to rescue sinners. Jesus laid down his life for his sheep so they could have forgiveness and eternal life. When we trust in Jesus, we are his sheep who listen to, follow, and obey him.
Wow, what an awesome video. I loved getting to learn that Jesus is the good shepherd who cares for his sheep. You know, he didn't watch after actual sheep, but we are like sheep. We need Jesus to guide us, to care for us, to protect us, because we're all sinners, but God sent Jesus to rescue sinners. Jesus laid down his life on the cross for his sheep so that they could have forgiveness, so that we can be forgiven of our sins and have eternal life. When we trust in Jesus, we get to become his sheep who listen to him and follow him and obey him. So why do you guys think that Jesus compares us to sheep? What do you think? Maybe ask your brother or sister what they think. Talk about it with your family just for a minute. Why do you think that Jesus compares people to sheep? Those are really good thoughts you guys had. Yeah, I think it's important for us to remember that we are like sheep because we require guidance. Like, sheep wander off on their own. They'll wander into danger. They're not able to save themselves. They need a shepherd to watch after and to care for them. You might remember from the Old Testament when we learned about David. Before he became king of Israel, he was actually a shepherd and he would fight off bears and lions and crazy things like that. He would do anything to protect his sheep. And David wrote in Psalm 23 that the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. So really, we see that we are like sheep because we're unable to lead ourselves. We're unable to thrive without Jesus, our perfect shepherd. He leads us, he guides us, he cares for us. And so the question is, how do we get to become part of Jesus' flock? How do we get to be one of his sheep? What do you think? Talk about that with your family for just a second. How do you get to become part of Jesus' flock? So there's nothing that we can do on our own to become part of Jesus' flock. In fact, the only way to become part of his flock is to have faith in Jesus. We can't earn salvation on our own, but God gives it freely to all people who believe the truth of the gospel. So we have to believe that Jesus is real and that what he says is right and that he is better than all things. Jesus saves us and he makes us part of his flock by grace through faith alone. It's all his work, and so we get to be part of his flock and worship him because of that. And I want you guys to look back at John 10 real quick. I want you to look at verse 28. It says, "I give them eternal life and they will never perish and no one will snatch them out of my hand." So we have to know that if we're part of Jesus' flock, no one is able to snatch us out of Jesus' hand. He perfectly protects us and keeps us safe if we are his sheep. So how do you feel knowing that no one can snatch us from Jesus? Turn again to your brother, your sister, your mom, and your dad. Talk about that with them. How do you feel knowing that no one can snatch you from Jesus? Man, I don't know about you all, but it makes me feel so thankful that no one can snatch me out of the hand of Jesus. Because all who have faith in Jesus get to have eternal life with Jesus forever. And on my own, as a sheep, I would wander away after other things. And so I'm so thankful to know that Jesus is going to care for me and protect me always, forever. And you can be part of that through faith in Jesus. And that kind of reminds me of our big picture question. Does anyone remember what it is? The kind of the big question we've been talking about the last few weeks. It's what did Jesus teach when he was on earth? So again, think about that with your family. See if you can remember the answer to our big picture question. What did Jesus teach when he was on earth? What do you think? That's right. Very, very good. Jesus taught about God and his kingdom. And he taught that all scripture is about him. Because Jesus' teachings are recorded in God's word, we get to know a lot about God. Jesus' role on earth was to live a perfect life and to die as a perfect sacrifice for sin and to come back to life to defeat death. And a part of his perfect life was telling people about God and God's kingdom. Jesus wanted people, he wants everyone to know God personally. His work on the cross made it possible for us to understand and obey God's word. And so a question I want to ask you guys is, who can you tell about what you've learned today? Who can you share this story with, that Jesus is the good shepherd who cares for his people? Maybe it's a friend or a sibling, but think about someone who you can tell these amazing truths to later today or later this week. Man, isn't it awesome that Jesus taught that the whole Bible is about him? And so that means anytime we open and read the Bible, no matter what part of the Bible it is, we get to know who Jesus is more and more, and we can love him more, and we can follow him more and more. But that can be hard sometimes, right? Like, the Bible is really big. It can be sometimes challenging to understand. But we have help in that. God sends us his Holy Spirit to help teach us the truths about Jesus that we read in his word. And that's kind of what our memory verse has been about the past few weeks. Does anyone remember where it was from? That's right. We just have to flip a few pages forward. It's in John chapter 14, verses 25 and 26. I've got it right here for you guys. It says, "These things I have spoken to you while I am still with you. But the Helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all that I have said to you." So I hope you guys have been able to work on learning that over the past few weeks, but it teaches us the important truth that the Holy Spirit helps us learn more and more who Jesus is as we read his word. So let's go ahead, let's get up, let's sing and dance a little bit as we listen to and sing our song that will help us learn our memory verse more and more. Are you ready? Let's do it.
While I've been made with you, but the counselor.
you guys enjoyed that song as much as I did. I hope you got to sing along and show off some of your awesome dance moves, all the while you're learning about Scripture, right? So I hope you had a great time today. I hope you learned some new things. Just a couple questions I want to give to you guys to just help summarize what you've learned today is, what did this story teach you about Jesus? What did you learn about Jesus today? And then what did you learn about yourself? What did this story teach you about Jesus? And what did this story teach you about yourself? And then finally, again, who can you tell about this story today? Who can you share the good news of Jesus with this week? All right, well, that is all I have for you guys today. I hope you had a great time with me on AG Kids Online. I'm going to go ahead and close in prayer. Jesus, thank you so much that you are the good shepherd and that you care for us. And that even though we cannot save ourselves and we wander away, that if we have faith in you, that you lead us, you guide us, and you protect us. So we thank you that we are your sheep through what you did on the cross. And God, we pray that you would help us tell other people about that so they can be your sheep as well. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Bye, everyone. Have a good week.